Ghostly greetings, my dudes. Ghostly greetings, and it's Holler at Your Boy, Prue. It is a book haul, and you saw the tag. I know you're thinking, Prue, I thought you said you were going to do these a lot less. I really, really was. But Christmas came, and I got some awesome books, and I'm very excited. So I got 2-3 reviews coming and some awesome books. So very excited. Let's just get right in the book haul, make these shorter. And just while we're here, I got a sore bear. She's being extra cuddly. She doesn't like to cold everyone. So probably for winter, she will be being a lot more videos. She's also super adorbs, aren't you? Yeah. Yeah, you're adorable. Okay. I try to do this, I guess, with a cat on the lap. The old cat on the lap videos. Maybe? Okay, we're not. Awesome. The Passage by Justin Cronin. I forgot who wrote this, I'm not going to lie. But I'm very excited about this. I had the bigger hard version, but I gave it to a friend of mine who really, really wanted to read it when the show came out, and I just never got it. And me and a friend, we went to Half Price Books, and they had it. Love it. Amazing. Oh, that's a series. I don't know the Impress That series. I'm doing a read-along with some people. I got a review coming up for the first book, but this one is Tender of the Flesh. I'm this far into it. And look at this awesome Kona Wave bookmark I got. Awesome sauce. I'm very excited about this. I know I say that about every book, but this is really cool. This is our next book that we're reading, and this is blew up BookTube for a while. And that's kind of a lot of these are like BookTube classics, if you will. And I really thought this had a cool premise. I attempted veganism. It wasn't for me. It was very hard. Food wasn't so bad, but all the other stuff I use in my life. So, Tenders of Flesh. I'm taking this one back downstairs because I'm going to try to read 2 chapters a day. And we're going to have that done in a week. So, I'm very excited. And then on Friday, I have to order Merciless. And that'll be the next one. But, Cabin Fever. It's about the ship. The harrowing narrative of cruise ship Zadam, which set sail daily days before the COVID-19, and then it went lockdown. So the ship was stuck at sea and basically couldn't land, from what I'm gathering. And I've been kind of on a survival kick with reading a nonfiction kick. And yeah, this was totally a cool find. I'm very happy I got this. Again, like I said, a BookTube classic, Bird Box by Josh Malerman. I love any Josh. Josh's all stick together. In Kentucky or Kansas, there was the great battle of the Josh's, and I didn't get to go to it. But Josh Malerman, and he wrote this crazy book, and I didn't really care for the movie. It's okay, but I hear the book's better, and I kind of gives a thing of the monster, and I think the monster's Cthulhu. Pruitt loves Cthulhu. I love Cthulhu. I love the mythos. Huge Lovecraft fan. One day I will go to Providence, Rhode Island and see the Tomb of the Messiah, HPL. And I will. But this is very Cthulhu-esque. I'm hoping the book's good. It's 260 pages. So a lot of these are really short, which I'm really excited about because trying to read chunkers sucks. But this looks like a lot of fun. And I'm really digging it. Okay, so a bit of a childish thing I got was Strange Case of Origami Yoda and Darth Paper Strikes Back. I really am looking forward to reading these two. I really enjoy both of these, and these just look like a lot of fun. These might be what I call fillers, where it's like, oh, I'm supposed to start a new book on Monday, but it's Thursday and I finished my book, and I always like to have something I'm reading. I like to keep these around, or bathroom books. You know, your boy Pruitt has a bathroom book, and I just want to, these look like a lot of fun. And I got both these for like $1 a piece, so yeah. Dude, cheap fun is, never look down entertainment. I always say that. If there's some free entertainment, take it. If there's cheap entertainment, take it, because worst case scenario, you find something you love. All right, last two. I got Dean Koontz, not a huge Koontz fan, but this looked really cool. One Way Door from Heaven, super chunkers. It's a thick one, it's a big one, but that looks really cool. I'm really excited to read that one. I'm just hoping that it lives up to the cover. It says mystery. I like a good mystery. And last but not least, book two. I don't know why I bought book two, because I don't have book one of the Sellsword Saga, but it was in super cheap. It was in the hardback. It's in the library discard bin. And I really worry, like, I don't like when books get discarded. I just want to take them home. And then if I have a friend who's like, oh, man, I'm really into sci-fi, or really, you know, fantasy, I'll give some of these cheap free books away, which is awesome. So, but I love R.A. Salvatore, and I love Drizzt. So this seems like an awesome, awesome cheap find. But that's it. I got a couple other books that I'm going to save for another book haul. And I'm currently reading two of them, so I don't want to bring them upstairs and go into the bedroom. But it's been your boy, Prue. And this has been a Sore Bear. And you know what? Y'all stay creepy. Deuces.